Okay, I will mention in this video how much time should you allocate to research something and whether you should see the product prior to buying it. So is it enough to just view it online or should you go to the physical store and see it? For someone, I did a research for computer cases. And it's simple, just Google. All the searches in here are Amazon products, so this is very simple. Search for Amazon, and it shows you a big list of cases, and you just, sometimes you filter. So for cases, you want cases which are not very small. There are also some bigger. Tower, you know what you want, so you filter like ATX. If you search for a keyboard, you probably want a USB. So there are minimum criteria which you want. So ATX, perhaps others, but I would just recommend you to filter as little as possible. But if you don't want a small case, that's clear, you want ATX. If you don't want gaming, okay, ATX. But avoid filtering until you have just a few cases left to see. So after a small filter, you get this list of cases, and pretty much all of the cases in this list are good, some better than others. So there are various price ranges, so most likely this case is not as good as this case, but this is more expensive, so you have to decide. So, but this is a very bad case, so it has a minimum quality, I expect. So anyhow, I looked at this page and I looked at the second page of result, and on the second page there was this case, and it had a promotion and a good price in Romania, so for that person I bought this case. So this was the case, and very happy, very joy, oh, happy days. So I bought this case. I later bought another case like this, so very cool. Until recently I looked at this case, which has a price which is higher than the other one, but not 100% higher, just higher. And it also comes on white, and it looks so gorgeous, and it's like, the price is like 30-40% higher. So it's some increase in price, but it looks so much better. And I really regret a bit. So I don't like returning products, even if I bought it and then I just soon discovered this one. I will not take the case back, but still, this looks much better. So, yeah, you should research it, and for the case, you don't need to see it a lot, but read a lot of reviews. So let's say you buy a mouse. You Google mice, and I own this product, which is good. Until you click on it, and you see it's huge. This is not an actual representation, but this mouse is huge. A very, very big mouse. It's got like huge... I didn't see the video. Let's see a bit. So this is the video.
One tiny receiver.
No, it doesn't show.
Logitech unifying receiver.
Anyhow, it's just a huge mouse. So prior to buying it, I really drooled over the aspect. It looks nice. So when they made a similar mouse, looking similar to the other one, I was excited. Look, this mouse, pretty much the same, much smaller and very cheap. It was a very cheap mouse. But since they stopped producing it, I don't know. Perhaps they copied the form of Logitech too much. I don't know. They didn't produce the exact mouse. And to my disappointment, it wasn't available anymore. But soon after, other producers started copying the form. I don't know, from Logitech or just a general trend, but... even Logitech made the mouse similar to its own Performance MX, and now it's got even higher. So when buying a mouse, I think you should buy it from the original store, or at least see it. So go to the store, watch it, have it in your mouth, in your hand, and just see it. See it, test it, see if it fits, look. This is not enough. You need to have it tested properly. Same for keyboard. I own this keyboard, so I did a Google, I looked, okay, this looked great. I went to the store And it was nice, and I'm very happy I bought this keyboard. It's ergonomic, it's cool, yeah, or perfect. Except for one little detail, let me see. The keys are very big. This is the only... Oh, yeah, another problem is that this should be F1, F2, F3, F4, and stop here, and from here, F5 to... So F5 is not placed as it you would expect it to be. So this is a bit strange. I use this button for play, pause my Winamp. So this is for music. I also use this button. This one, I use it for play pause on my computer. So I use, somebody calls me, I need to quickly stop the music. So this is, I have a button just for that on my keyboard and on my mouse. So whether I'm typing or I'm using the mouse, I need the key. There is a shortcut in Winamp, Control Alt Home, or Insert for play, Home for pause, and End for stop. But it's much better to just use this button. But the problem with the keys is that it has a long run to go. This is the only problem with the keyboard. And also I had some very nasty experiences with Microsoft keyboards. They just stopped working after a while. I used them and after a while they just didn't work anymore. So yeah, I'm looking on the internet. Look, this looks like an Apple keyboard. Very small... distance, but you need to test it. I wouldn't buy it just on after seeing it online, because you'll use this, it's like one of the most used interface with the computer, and it's not, it's $20. Instead of 20 you would buy a product which is 25 if you go to the store, let's say 30, perhaps even if you go to a store it's 50. If it's that much to you, go to the store, test it, and come and buy it online. If it's not too much trouble, just go to the store and buy the first one which you like and take it home. Because it's generally a cheap product with a big, big impact on your usage of the computer. You will not be happy with the keyboard. If you buy it online, and yeah, you can return it, but this why it's much simpler to just go in the store in the first place. If you take it home, return it, order another one, it's so much trouble that it's generally just preferable, okay, I will just go to the store and buy a keyboard from there. It's simpler this way. So even if you buy an expensive product, which is this, and when I bought it, it was even more expensive. So this is quite expensive, you know, it's not a very cheap keyboard if you compare to the other ones. But test it. I bought it from a real store. They had a good promo, but always test when you. So I will talk later about CPUs. You know, if it's not this one and this one, yes, it's a difference. But okay, it's unless you do video processing, it's not a big difference. But when you talk about a keyboard which you will personally feel for years to come, because they tend not to break that easily, and sometimes that's even a problem. You like it or not, you will use that keyboard very, very long time. So test it. Don't buy it online. And it's your personal preference. If you like a keyboard with a small running distance, so this is very small, buy this kind of keyboard. If you prefer this one, a long one, buy another one. There are some alternatives like illuminated keys. To me this is like so distracting, I would never use this. Or mechanical keys. So I don't know how to put this, but they have some sort of arc. I don't know. So when you click, it makes a sound. Click, click, click. It's a specific thing. It's a mechanical keyboard. Just research it for a while and you will see. So these are different kind of keys. Let's say you want to buy a CPU. In here, there's actually no point in going to a store. You could research everything you need to know. You never see the processor. Everything is well reviewed. And there are not like 1,000 options. There are Intel and AMD and a few series. You need to know what's the latest generation product. Some products are older and some products are newer. And you need to know which generation is old and which generation is new. You need to know a few things like K is meant for, is generally meant for overclocking. I bought this product. It's the 6-in-line. Yeah, it's quite simple, you know, not too fancy. So if I wanted the AMD, I would have bought this one. So it's not complicated, you know. Just go this one and read a few reviews and see what the processor is best aimed at. If you bought the processor, you will first you decide the processor and then you decide the motherboard, which has enough USBs and other stuff which you might require. So how many hard drives you would you connect, how many CD-ROMs, how many, I don't know, different motherboards have different requirements. So you need to research a bit, because now there's a new generation of SSD, and that new generation has a different type of connector than old hard drives and SSDs. And you need to Google a bit, you know, to find out, okay, so what's the difference between this very expensive new motherboard which has this port and this very cheap motherboard? Oh, it has this port which allows for new SSDs. Will I ever need to connect a newer SSD? Yes, perhaps. Okay, if yes, then buy the motherboard which has that connector. Okay. For cooling fan, I looked for CPU, but it was supposed to look for a cooling fan. So you go cooling fans, and you get results like this. Most of CPU. This is actually non-CPU, so I'm not in the right. Okay, fans and cooling. This is what I want it, and case fans. So you go to case fans and you find the case fan which you like, and you just from the first pick a CPU which you like. A backpack. Go to Google. Now in this case, I would generally suggest you to just test it. But there was a promotion and I bought a backpack just because it was very incredibly cheap. I paid so little that I'm ashamed even to say it. Very, very small price. You can't find that kind of thing at that specific price. So I just bought it and it turned out to work for me. Had it not, I would just have returned because it was a very good promo. And I would just bought it, but there was a 30% chance that I wouldn't like something of it, because yes, if this is a high product on Amazon, look what you see about it. So I just click randomly. I haven't checked it. So what's inside? You know, perhaps inside you will find. So this is you've seen, yeah? The third product on. Okay, so no photo from inside. So. Will you like it? Will it fit? Will it handle your camera well? You just need to buy it and hope it works. Or buy from a store. If you don't find any exceptionally good promotion, buy it from the physical store. Electric cord. Generally, I buy online. But I needed to buy a specific thing which was black. And I went to the store and just bought it from there. And it was a good choice. Headset. One store had a good promotion, something like this. Oh my god, the price! Look, the price! And I bought it and it had a 3 meters cable. And I thought it wouldn't be a problem, but it was. And now I have some problems with buying a 3 meters cable. Because I haven't checked, so you just click. Okay, what do I know about heads? No, it's okay. And it says perhaps somewhere in here, if you read carefully, it says it's a 3 meters cable. Perhaps, not this one, I bought a different thing. So it says perhaps, look, it has 3 meters cable, but you don't pay much attention and you think, okay, 3 meters cable, but it was a big problem. Flat TV. So, my father needed a flat TV, so he needed a bit of a research. Okay, flat TV, these are the cheapest ones, 72p. It's a big TV with only, so it's not full HD, but he won't need it as much, and even if it's smaller, it's fine. So, okay, my father is happy. Monitor. I just Google monitor, and this is a good product. This is a good product. It's high in the tops. There are much better products. So, Dell makes much. So, this is much, has a much better quality. It's the same monitor, like double the price. But double the price, so no. Okay, as a bottom line, for some products, you can only read things, you should only read things online. You don't need to. So CPU, just online. For other products, you really need to go to the store, like keyboard, like mouse. Others are in between, and it's a balance between price, commodity, and risk. So the price is smaller when you buy online. It's much more easy and nice and simple to have your product delivered at your door rather than go to some place to pick it up. But there's a risk, because you might order something and find out for various reasons it doesn't fit your needs very well. So yeah, it's this balance. You can't know exactly, so it's not 100% sure. You gotta take some risks. I like it online that you can also buy used, refurbished. So, you know, this product used, it's much cheaper than buying the product from a physical store, which is most likely always new. So these are my thoughts. I'll link to these and a few reviews I made to the products. Have a nice day.